Breaking news, Trump administration attacks the H-1B visa. Again. Welcome to Voice of Immigration. I'm your host, John Veely, immigration attorney and CEO of Online Visas, the intelligent immigration platform. The interim final rule to further restrict the use of the H-1B visa by U.S. companies to hire employees in specialty occupation jobs or those that require a minimum of a university degree has finally dropped. This comes on the heels of a bizarre announcement last Friday that the agency had withdrawn the agenda. But 4 days later, Acting DHS Secretary Chad Wolf said in a statement, "We have entered an era in which economic security is an integral part of homeland security. Put simply, economic security is homeland security," with his announcement of the new rule. This is important because they're going to have to recognize and rationalize why they dropped it as an interim final rule instead of leaving it open to comment for 60 days. They're going to have to come up with a national interest issue, and that's what they're trying to do here. The updated regulations redefine specialty occupations, limit the validity of the H-1B visa to 1 year for workers placed at third-party worksites, and increase the enforcement tools to police companies that do not abide by the H-1B visa rules or cooperate with the site visits. At the same time, a new Department of Labor rule is slated to go into effect, requiring employees to increase what they pay H-1B recipients in an effort to discourage companies from undercutting American workers. Will be interesting to see how high those prevailing wage requirements are. The rules, which do not go into effect for 60 days, would heighten requirements for businesses to hire foreign workers on the H-1B visa, according to the details reviewed by numerous publications we read today. The changes may be challenged in court, as the rule was done without a public comment period, as we discussed above, and an interim final rule in order to expedite how quickly it can go into effect. It may face serious challenges in court as Trump's ban on the issue of H-1B visas was overturned by a federal court just last Friday on a similar argument. It is my conversations with litigators today that this rule will be attacked immediately. They've been looking forward to it. They've been watching it. They've been litigating against these other things, and they're likely to move very, very quickly on it. So look at the actions by the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, who won the case overturning the H-1B ban in the Northern District of California, and looked at John Wasden, the attorney that defeated the Trump contract and itineraries memo in March in the case of IT Serve Alliance, drastically reducing the strategies USCIS has been used to deny H-1B visas. If you're watching this on YouTube and you want to stay up with these ever-changing issues, please subscribe and turn on your notifications. Please like and share. I'm John Veely, CEO of Online Visas, the intelligent immigration platform where we deliver dreams.